I'll change the record back to So for any of you just popping in, and for YouTube playing some scam rack, discard based strategy, trying to lean into the scam package, with the not dead after alls, undying evil effects, griefs, as well as bowmasters and dothies as extra creatures alongside that to give some extra value. And then a smattering cyborg cards to fight the meta. Not making any changes, just gonna run it back. See if we can play just a little bit tighter and do better than 3-2. Check my work schedule for next month. Are waiting. Ugh. Up against the last Rita, we're on the play. And we don't have a okay, so we have like the double or work hand. I think we keep. It's kind of a sketchy keep, honestly. But any land lets us play stuff. So it looks like we're playing against the zoo deck. Land. All right, well, this feels awful, but here we are. And this is kind of why I hate playing the four Urborgs. They might have bowl open. Well, maybe I should have done this end of their turn so we don't get stubby deed. Scion, spooky. Do I just play second Dothy here? Or do I hold up Undying Evil, Not Dead After All? I think I play second Dothy. They can't counter it, and then next turn if they go Leyline of the Guild Pact, we can downtick with Lily, assuming we draw land. Tribal Flames, okay. I'm actually, no, we can't. I was going to say we could Tribal Flames this, but we can't because of We don't have the mana base that they have. I guess we just go to combat. All right. We just got there. Just got there. Pithy Needle doesn't do anything in this matchup. And then I'll just get rid of the Wrench Mind. This hand doesn't do enough. It's got this hand's much better. I think we put back a rack. This hand's not like powerful or anything, but I should have kept the rack. Every time I do that. I think we'll start out by griefing them. We don't have the combo. But I want to take their Scion if they have one. Just Kavu. They drew Flooded Strand for turn. Plains. Gigant out of hand. Well, I'm gonna hold on to that Urborg. For next turn. We're not gonna get to make constructs here. Our opponent's saying some not swell things in chat. Yeah. All right, yeah. He's basically saying that I'm lucky. So I'm not gonna. There's not really a point in repeating anything that he said. Just move on. I mean, the thing is like it's not The scam kind of does that, I think, to people. But, you don't have to be a dick. Yeah, he's playing zoo. He's like, he said, I'm playing with two lands and I still win. And I'm like, Zoo regularly wins by playing two lands. Like, that Zoo deck, it's like, okay, turn one, like if you have your ley line, you go like turn one monkey, like turn two play Zion, and then your creatures have hexproof for the rest of the game. Like, it's like definition of non-interaction, So. But he was like, yeah, you're playing two ends and you're winning. I'm like, okay, don't ever play Legacy because people are winning off of much less than that. Well, we get to do the thing, so. Opponent mulls a five. So this is going to be pretty brutal. We'll take the. Thoughtseize. I think we take the push too. All right, maybe if we can draw another Thoughtseize spell, we can take their Karn, kind of seal the game up. So our opponent is dead unless they draw removal. Okay. That counts. So they play the Karn and then we kill them with a factory. Are they just hoping that I miss lethal? Wrench of Mind comes out. I think Shadow Spear comes out. They've got Dothies, but or they've got Bowmasters, but I don't think it's right keeping in the pushes. And a part of me wants to keep pushes in. I wonder if any is anything better or worse than, like, I kind of want to keep two pushes in. I can cut a rack to do that. I could cut a rack and then cut and not bring in like Ashiok. We didn't see Profane Tutor. Maybe on the play, I'll bring it in. On the play, and then if we see Profane Tutor, I'll bring in Ashiok. But the thing is, they also sometimes play like Dothies. They might bring them in because we are. They might expect us to be boarding out our removal versus them. Okay. All right. Maybe we see Dothy go here. Maybe they take grief. Oh, they took grief. Right, they push. They don't have third land. So it could be right to start plussing. So they get the ring. They probably get Cabal Coffers next turn. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play out Lily, and the next turn I'll go Damping Sphere. Because if they go for Coffers, I want them to go for Coffers so I can play the Damping Sphere. Okay, so I kill Lily. Lily did some work there. And now we turned off their combo. So what are we naming here? Are we naming Karn or the One Ring? Probably Karn. So we're going to name Karn, and the reason why we name Karn is because Karn just represents a One Ring. And Karn is how they deal with the stuff on the board. They bowmaster us. Oh, they Field of Ruin. They demo field our castle. Sure. Thought sees you. I will take your Bowmaster, I think. Huh. We'll take your March. Land would be good. Let us cast our grief. They could keep trying to strip mine us if they wanted. We only play so many basics. I'm actually going to take the Emrakul here. That's the thing I'm most scared about. Like, I think that it's very possible that they can cast that card. I don't know why I clicked out Bowman. All right. If they want to bowmaster this, I'm happy with that trade. They should have just pinged me. Since they'd have to assign two blockers to this anyways. All right, we're not like out of, we're not like, 100% to win from here, but they have one turn to draw something. All right, 2-0. Totally forgot that it was trying to look at my schedule. Sick. Okay. I was like trying to get off the camping, some days for camping next month, and it looks like I got them. So exciting. It's kind of funny, Dan. I was texting someone, my the person I was going camping with, that I got the time off, and they said, "Yay!" Like with as many whys as you did too. We'll keep. If we draw into a if we draw into a what do you call it? Scam effect. Do I want to do? I probably ditch the lily here, right? Maybe I should have bottomed it. Goif. Oh. Huh. Interesting. We probably take our Malakir Rebirth here. I think that it's probably worth it to scam this grief. Deny them the land. Now we just got a race to see who draws their we're racing right now, so it's do they draw their shardless effect first, and I think we have to. Yeah. No, they can't draw land and oh, do we not have? Oh, we don't have graveyard hate other than Dothy. We don't have a Damn it. I was like, oh man, we're so good. We're gonna like totally we're gonna totally get them. We'll get our Nile spell bomb, but no graveyard hate other than Dothy game one. I mean, we could get there, you know. They kept card on top, which is awful for us. Well, this is fine. So they go Shardless, right? We sack Dothy in response. We're actually not going to cast anything. So the hilarious thing is that, like, if we draw into another Dothy. If we draw into another Dothy, we can just wipe their clear their board. They get to rearrange our deck, which is kind of meh. And they get three food tokens. And we get to keep doing this. So as long as they do that at sorcery speed, we get to keep doing this. Now, the Fatal Push is a cool draw because it allows us to attack. And this is a sick draw, too. They're digging for it. So question is okay, so we do this. We not dead after all, target Dothy. Make me sacrifice it. It dies, and then it comes back. I think this is right. And we have to do it again. They get some tokens, you know. Some some food tokens. I think I push, target their Architect of Wills, while Dothy is on the battlefield. It's one less creature. To deal with. All right. I don't know how. I think Living End only runs three, right? They only run three of those effects. Okay, they go up to seven. Play land, pass. And then we kill them. Wow. That was crazy. This Dothi Voidwalker just soloed our living end opponent. He just We have a lot of hate for this matchup. I'm putting the chalices over here. You may have commented before I did that. So I recognize there's like a lag. What's Shelly's Edict is probably mid. Necromentia is probably a card I wanted to bring in. We have one piece of graveyard hate, so we'll keep. No, Force of Vigor was pretty good. Thoughtseize. Take their subtlety. I'll play this Urborg out. Feels bad, but if they start cycling, I want to respond. They kept a card on top. Maybe it's subtlety. Oh, okay. Well, they've Got the outburst. So they get to get the ant back. We'll just play this out for future ones. I don't know what's in their hand anymore. Yeah, that's kind of the downside. I did bring in Ashiok, I think. I'm just gonna see what's in their hand. Nothing. Okay. This we get hit for 9, and then I think we die. So we just got beat by the regular beats. They had a pretty sick line. And that's sort of the downside of bringing out all of the like bringing in so much hate, is that we end up losing to their fair game plan. Turok is like sort of hilarious. The Inquisitions miss a lot. Yeah, I'll bring in Necro. And I think I bring in Turok. Sands. It's a little hilarious. So we'll try to take grief. Dothy would be pretty cool here. Another discard spell would be pretty cool here. I'm going to grief them. To try to get I'm gonna take their blue card so they can't subtlety me. I don't really want to give them a 2/2. Dothy with not dead after all right now is so sick. I was gonna use it for living end, but now that we have Yeah, I think we're good. Opponent had like some mild salt in chat. But Living End always has it, so I don't feel bad about He just said easy, or they just said easy draw. I'll admit, like, our draw was like pretty good, and being on the play that game was like essential. Sorry guys, I gotta take a phone call. All right, I'm gonna give him a call back after this league. I think we know stuff. Our draw was like, it's kind of stupid this game. I mean, we'll just do it again next turn, so. I'd love to draw a black land. Didn't specify. This could be like the mono white, or it's like a green white deck that has that recurring one drops. enchantment. Huh. Sure. So opponent is teched a little bit for us. I think that Turok is probably good versus the white deck. I like Pithing Needle. I might Karak to bring in a Soul Guide Lantern. Wrench Mine, I'm not as big a fan of. I don't know if Push is good. So we saw Ensnaring Bridge out of their deck, so I don't think that we're gonna be wanting to be on creatures too much. I might just want to bring in another Needle over a Push. We're running like that. Little pick of my cat. We'll keep. If we draw into a Oh, okay. I'm gonna play out the rack to try to bait them into using their march on that instead of my Dothy. All right. I won't chalice. I won't play one drops. Saga, okay. I'm thinking of actually sacking a Dothy here. To blow up their Saga. And then we can get our we might want to do the same thing and play their saga. Karn. So we'll kill Karn. Oh, we drew the pithing needle. Huh. Do we hit them or do we play Saga? Because if we play Saga, then they have to spend their turn demo fielding. We're definitely killing Karn. Know what? Yeah, we'll attack them. Now they have to try to. Now we have lethal on board, and unless they can empty, they can get cards out of their hand. I feel pretty good. They need to be able to like draw a card, play bridge, and get. They go to 5-4 by playing bridge, and then they need to play two more cards. Which they might be able to do if they do Okay, rest in peace. Play Karn. Say go. Next turn we kill their bridge. Oh yes, Chalice is zero, so all right, 4-0. See if we can get there. Who is our final boss? I love playing I love playing Karn, the Great Creator, and these like Pox based strategies. Like in I played like a bit of Legacy Pox, like Karn Pox, and like ritualing out a Karn and then take like liquid metal coating them, is or like, Mycosynth Wellspring. Or sorry, Mycosynth Lattice, like lattice locking people. I missed the modern era where that combo was legal. I wish this webcam had zoom. Right, we're gonna skip. This hand doesn't do broken things. But it's a pretty standard like rack hand. So we are playing against the mirror. We'll take monkey. I wouldn't necessarily say it's a good matchup, but we've got game against it. We'll push this. And then we get to push their Dothy next turn. Alternatively, I could hold the push. Let's just go. Wrench mine, make them discard. And then we'll play the Lily out next turn. Maybe they play like a sorcery speed creature. Just like that. Shadow. Okay. Push. Edict. Not bad. So they kill Lily because they have to. They ask for five. Maybe more. Six. Discard spell. So I want to have two blockers this turn. Is that crazy? Can they kill me? If I hit them to four, if I hit them to four, this will be a 9-9. I have a blocker. I'm gonna get another blocker. Okay. Damnation comes in. It's actually not quite the mirror, this is shadow. Pithing needle. I don't know if I want pithing needle. I think that this is good. Well, if we get to, if they don't discard spell us, we get to do the thing turn one. Hopefully they just play monkey. It's like the only time I've ever want them to play monkey instead of discard spell on turn one. Malachar Rebirth. Undying Evil's better, I think, to discard here. We'll take a Thoughtseize. Hopefully it's not push. Just Lily. Oh, they have land. Sad. I think oh man, I should have I should have played Undying Evil instead of the Not Dead After All because of this, because it comes in on play untapped. Yeah. I was weirdly prioritizing the life loss. So if we lose this game, it's me. Oh, fuck. I punted this game. I punted by not playing the Undying Evil there. So if we don't, and I think that, no, I could have prevented the monkey. I could have prevented the monkey. A 100%. I think we have to get rid of this Malakir Rebirth. Yeah, I messed up. I think I win that game 9 times out of 10 if I play the my cards right. And I didn't. I totally messed up. I kind of wish I kept that first hand now. Okay. Wish I could keep this Bowman for the monkey. Well, maybe we scrape by. Jeff, you summoned it to our hand. All right, can we get the land? To be fair, we only started with one. A rack is also a suitable spell. Because now it makes grief a lethal attacker next turn. And then discard spell. So I think we have this in the bag. Our opponent goes to one, and then we have a lethal attacker. Like, they can't kill this because then they draw. They lose the life. I'm gonna take this block. Okay, 5-0. Oh man. So despite my punt in game, despite my punt in game, two of the last match, I was able to pull the 5-0. Oh my God, Pokevod, thank you so much. Oh, shit, man. Thank you. Unfortunately, I can't take credit for this deck list. But yeah, thank you, Pokemon, for the 3 months. Thought we were doing pretty good with With a 3-2 from the first game, I at least have some content to upload. I think the last time I opened this many, I collected like, I don't know, 200 or 300 play points, just high rolled on it all. Man, I'm like shaky right now. It's always so tense in the 5-0, like the last game. Oh, dude, this deck has so much play. Like I like my creatureless deck, rack deck, but this deck fucks, you know? Yeah. So sick. Yeah, grief is nuts. It's that's a hell of a drug, for sure.